Welcome to the management level case study analysis for August 2019. Before I start analyzing the case, please have a piece of pen and a paper so that you can write down the notes. If I have missed anything which you are thinking, you can mention in the comment box so that I will be able to reply. Before we start the August analysis, I need to mention for August 2019, there is no syllabus change. There is no syllabus change for August 2019. And students, the only changes will be the F2 areas, which was mentioned even in the last time, that is IFRS 16, which is lease. Then you have, there is another standard called IFRS 15, which is revenue contracts. And then there is another standard, which is the most important standard for the F2 subject, which is IFRS 9, financial instruments. Financial instruments. So students, before we start the case, once again, I am reminding you, the case study exam focuses on skills. And I think you know the skills which they focus on. One is the technical skill. Technical skill is usually the book knowledge, the theory knowledge what you acquired. The book knowledge what you acquired. The book knowledge what you acquired. Then you have the business skill, which is the industry knowledge. Business skills, which is the industry knowledge. Now, students, you may be aware that this time the industry is cruise industry. So they have already given you the pre-seam so that you can analyze it. Then the people skill usually concentrate on the characters which is mentioned in the case study. Again, I am repeating, the people skill consists of the characters that is mentioned in the pre-seam. And then students, the leadership skill which involves your decision-making skills and also your judgment. Basically, the ethical reasons which are hidden, you can consider as the leadership skill. Now, students, I think we can start working with the case analysis. So, August 2009 management case study analysis, pre-seen material. Cruise Calm, this is a service industry. So, first thing I am going to mention here, it's a service industry and it's a leisure industry where people spend, just to spend their excess time they have during holidays. Last time they were testing a manufacturing industry, Jode Homes, where they had a construction. So this time it's a service industry and it's not ship manufacturing, it is cruise service like airline services. Cruise service like airline services where they will be taking passengers from one destination to another destination for their enjoyment. Now students, Cruise Calm. When you look at the case, you can clearly understand that this company, Cruise Calm, is usually a calm company. In other words, they are focusing on a very relaxation. So I will just mention here, relaxation. So students, business knowledge, you need to understand, it's mostly on the relaxation they need to have. So students, just going through the contents so that it will give you a lot of idea. Now, if you look at the industry knowledge they have mentioned, I can clearly say the industry introduction will be business skill, a people skill. In other words, what job you are doing, they may mention, and the company's details. And cruise industry they have mentioned, that is focusing on the business skill. So students, you need to clearly study this area in detail. I'm not telling you to memorize it, but you need to get in this detail. Instead of memorizing, you need to absorb the contents. You need to absorb the contents so that in the examination, you will save a lot of time rather than looking at the pre-seen. A Cruise Calm history, again, business skill. A Cruise Calm business model, again, business skill. Cruise Calm marketing, again, business skill. Cruise Calm's management style, business skill and leadership skill. Extracts from monthly performance report, that you can have a little bit of technical skill, business skills also. and extracts from Kruskal's annual report, again business skill. Extracts from Whalen annual report, this is a competitor analysis, so business skill, a technical skill, and sorry, in the previous one also there is a little bit of technical skill. And then the most important thing, the newspaper articles, which is the current issues in the industry. So students, in the past examinations, they usually build the unseen based on the newspaper article. Around 70% chances are there, they develop the unseen based on the newspaper articles which has been given. So students, you need to be absorbing it, not memorizing it. Absorbing it, memorizing it. Not memorizing, absorbing. So keep that in mind, students. Now students, let's come to the introduction. So here, Kruskal is a quoted company. So I will just underline quoted company. So there can be chances of WACC, weighted average cost of capital. There can be listing things that can be tested in the exam. Corporate governance can come in the point of view. So students, please be careful. This is a listed company. So you need to be very much strong in these areas. You need to be very much strong in this area. And students, I think you may be aware there is a topic called cost of debt, cost of equity. So students, please study the cost of equity section, where they may ask you to recalculate the cost of equity in this region. And this is a quoted company. Please keep that in mind, students. This is the quoted company. And I think after two sessions, this is the first time they are giving you a quoted company. So please keep that in mind, students. And also you can get on long-term finance topic like bond issues, everything. And also students, IAS 33, EPS, please keep that in mind, which is very, very important for the knowledge. The company operates a fleet for holiday cruise ships. So students, please circle this holiday. So I think it is seasonal demand, because students, you don't get holidays every year. So you will have a seasonal demand. Christmas holidays will be there, summer vacations will be there, midsummer vacation will be there. So you need to be very much careful. It's a seasonal demand. A Kruskal is based in Patora, a major city in Norland. Patora, look at the name, Patora. So I think it's closer to the ports, or it's closer to the sea, offers extensive shipping facilities. So we are correct there. So they provide good shipping facilities and is a major business center. So I think this is a hub for the cruise. So that's a competitive advantage, I can say, or I can say that's one of the key reasons, critical success factors for this organization, CSF. Norland is a developed country, so you need to be very much careful. In the pest analysis, economical factor, you can understand Norland is a developed country. So developed country people, you should have exposable or disposable income they may be having. That has a high standard of living. The average age of the population is relatively high, with large number of citizens who can afford to indulge themselves in expensive holidays. So their target segment is mostly appropriate in this country. So they may have a local demand also. So students, I think you may be aware about something called Porter's Diamond Theory. Please keep in mind Porter's Diamond Theory, where they may be testing it in detail, because they have a local demand, and related and supporting industries also can come in this area. Norland currency is N$. So students, please be careful. There is a topic called IAS 21, which is foreign currency translation. So you need to be very much careful with this section. Companies are required to prepare their financial statement in accordance with IFRS. So students, you need to anticipate. In other words, you need to expect one question. The last trigger can be a question where they are testing the accounting standards. You are a finance manager in Kruskal's head office. Please keep in mind, you are a finance manager in Kruskal head office. Your primary responsibility associated with management accounting, so P2 knowledge is very important. You report to the senior financial manager, who directly reports to the finance director. So you have a coordination role where you need to be very much sensitive in decision making. So students, please keep this in mind. This is the hierarchical structure in this organization. So I believe that you are taking this down. So I will scroll down to the next page. The cruise industry, very, very interesting. They're telling the cruise industry is a major element of global tourism industry. I do agree with that, students. There are approximately 50 cruise lines offering wide range of experience that includes the following services. Please keep that in mind. Only 50 cruisers are there in this case. Ocean cruisers, generally associated with vacations that last for 1 or 2 weeks. So I will just underline this 1 or 2 weeks, which is 14 days maximum. Each cruise has a itinerary, stopping and predetermined port of call. Ocean cruises are generally provided using large cruise ships that offer comfortable accommodation even when they encounter rough seas. So students, this is a very, very sensitive business because there is high chances of rough sea. So there can be a risk that can be tested. The next one is the river cruise. Generally involve vacation up to a week, which is 7 days. The previous one was 14 days. The river itinerary usually follows the navigable river, stopping at cities and other points of interest along the way. The ships used for river cruises are generally much smaller than those for ocean cruises, but they still offer comfortable accommodation. So I think ocean cruises is the most expensive one, and this is the second expensive one. Specialty cruises, they clearly take the host to different form, ranging from itineraries that might not attract typical cruise passengers to traditional cruises that are promoted with the view of attracting specific clientele. For example, expedition cruises may require ships that are designed to operate high-risk environments such as polar ocean. I think students, you can see the picture clearly here. They are going mostly on the adventures. Passengers might have the opportunity to go ashore the adventure activities or to observe local wildlife. Specifically, specialty cruisers can also use normal ocean-going cruise ships to visit holiday destination, but with the additional themed activities while cruising. For example, itinerary cruise embark famous authors who are paid to give talks about their works in the ship theaters and interact with passengers in organized workshop. Passengers have grown steadily for the past decade, with 28.4 million confirmed passengers for booking in 2018. So students, industry-wise, this is a very good industry that you need to keep in mind. And also students, specialty cruise, ocean cruise, and also they have given river cruise. So I can just mention here, there can be BCG matrix that can be compared here. So again, I can say Ansoff matrix, you can just recall this knowledge so that you can apply this in the cases. And then students, let's move to the next area, the global cruise passengers. So I told you it is steadily increasing, and you can see that the increment is very high because of senior citizen and middle-aged people. But students, there can be a situation of threat of new generation. For example, the current generation usually spend more time in mobile phone rather than real life adventures. So there can be threat if there is no proper sustainable plan. Worldwide, there are approximately 50 cruise lines. This is repeating for the second time in the case. So you need to keep that in mind. So you need to mention this in the case study also when you are writing the answer. 50 cruise lines should be in your mind, which operates totally 480 ships. So this is the size of the market. Ocean cruises are far the most popular, with some of those taking the form of themed specialty cruise. River cruises and adventure type specialty cruises tend to be offered by companies which are designed for the niche market. So keep that in mind. Most ocean cruises are for even 7 or 14 nights. We discussed this previously. Generally, passengers fly from their home country to join the ship. So I will underline this fly from home country. So there is a related industry, which is the airline. The flight industry is there, where they need to travel by flight in order to join the cruise. So there can be indirect impacts also in the future. If the prices of the flight charges increases, there will be a direct impact in the cruise industry, even if there is no changes in prices. Their home country to join their ship during one of the designated port calls. At conclusion of their holiday, passengers disembark to fly home. Passengers choose their cruisers on the basis of both destination that they will be able to visit facilities offered by the ship. So I'll underline this, facilities offered by the ship. So this is a very important thing. You can apply the value analysis, cost benefit analysis also in the future. Ships make port at least once every 2 days on typical ocean cruises. Some regions have no so many potential destinations that it is possible to make a port in a new location every day. Ideally, the ship will sail at the night while the passengers are dining and sleeping, and will arrive at each new destination with sufficient time to disembark for sightseeing and other activities. Keep that in mind, students. Now students, let's come to the next page so that it will giving you more clearer picture, and they are clearly showing their facilities. Show visits tends to last for 8 to 12 hours, and they may not permit great deal of time ashore because logistical issues associated with passengers disembarking, passing through passport control and custom allowing sufficient time to return to the ship. So students, these are the operational issue that you need to keep in mind, and you should be very much organized also. Some stops involve tying up with a large port that require passengers to take buses to destination itself. So students, organizing is very important. There can be chances where you can drop one passenger and have a negative feedback. That is, he may be left alone or sometimes due to your negligence. The ocean cruise ships themselves are designed to make time spent abroad relaxing and enjoying. Passengers can generally choose between a variety of dining options with a range of different types of meal service on offer. The ships generally have public spaces that cater for diverse activity, including shopping, health and beauty spa, swimming pools and areas for sunbathing. Most ships have theaters that stage live shows featuring resident musicians, dancers and other acts that can be used to offer about the forthcoming destination. So students, this is mostly on the entertainment segment, and students, there can be operational issue where one of the performer is sick or not sick. So please keep that in mind. These are very sensitive industry. Cruisers are priced to take account of standards of service available on the ship, the number of show excursion and the standard of cabin. Most ships offer different classes of accommodation. More expensive cabins have bulkhead, a wall that is adjacent to the ship hull, and so they have windows and even balconies. Cheaper cabins are fully enclosed within the ship and do not have exterior windows. The cruise industry is adapting to reflect changing consumer taste and interest. Traditionally, cruisers were associated with older passengers who were prepared to buy expensive holiday that promising peaceful and relaxation. So students, keep in mind, this is senior citizens. The market still exists, but there is a growing demand for cruises for younger passengers. So students, there can be high chances where you are going to develop a sports type of cruise or an adventurous type of cruise for younger people. So there can be chances of investment appraisal topic that can be tested, including families with children. Those differ in terms of types of show visit offers, with greater emphasis on activities rather than sightseeing. For example, passengers may be taken ashore to the beach for a volleyball tournament and barbecue. So students, it's a new idea that they are developing, and in chances are there that can also be implemented in cruise come. The facilities offered by the ships will also differ, with entertainment being aimed at the younger audience and the shipboard activities such as basketball courts and climbing the wall. In comparison to traditional land-based package holiday, the pricing of the cruises can be complicated. So again, pricing issue is there, students. So pricing can be tested once again. So please revise those area from the P2 section. Traditional holidays are priced on the basis of a choice of destination, the time of the year and the class of the hotel. Potential holiday makers can easily compare price between different holidays offered by different holiday companies, because price quoted are largely all inclusive. Cruise holidays tends to offer more choices. Potential passengers are offered price based on the itinerary, but also there are significant additional charges that reflect further choices that can be made. For example, most ships offer different classes of cabin and different dining options. So students, inside the ships also there are price variation. For example, if you look at the airline industry, you have business class, economy class, like that they have differentiated. Passengers are also invited to pre-book a certain shipboard activities such as spa treatment and for offshore excursion. These choices can have significant effect on total cost of a cruise, which can complicate the booking process, and that can also make it difficult to choose between cruise companies. So that's one thing you need to keep in mind of the business area. So students, cruise come history. The steam mailboat company SMC was founded in 1890 to transport mail and general cargo to New Orleans outlying island. The company grew rapidly, winning major government contracts. So this is a very, very old company. SMC ships also offered cabins for paying passengers. Over time, the side of the business became a major source of revenue. By 1920, the company has divested itself from mail and cargo service and operating passenger-only service to a wide range of destinations. So keep that in mind, students. In those days, most long-distance travels was by rail or sea. Air travel was its infancy and extremely expensive during the introduction stages. SMC continued to grow until 1960s, when commercial aviation developed to the point where it offered a quick and relative alternative traveling ship. SMC sold its smaller ships and upgraded larger ships to offer luxurious passenger experience. SMC also invested in new ships that offers higher standards and conformance. So students, see here they are investing. So there is something called asset replacement cycle you need to keep in mind, because students, they have invested in 1960. Don't know whether they are using the same type of assets also there. In 1970, SMC changed its name to CruiseCom. So there is a restructuring in the name. So students, I can also say there can be restructuring. So please remember IAS 37 provisions and obtain listing on Nolan Stock Exchange. So there is a listing taking place in 1970. So this company is fairly old listed company. So you will not have any other issues on initial listing. So it's very clear. So there will be some problems in the dividends and the EPS calculation or the corporate governance. During the 1970s, the holiday industry went through major upheaval, with a significant increase in availability of charter airlines that enable holidays company to offer package holiday, combining flights and hotel accommodation in popular resorts. Many smaller cruise lines found it difficult to compete against the package holiday providers and were forced to close. CruiseCom's revenue was not so seriously affected by the change, because it was always aimed to be more luxurious end in the market. So students, like Titanic, this is one of the oldest company or a prestigious company to travel in. So please keep that in mind, students. It's a very, very important thing that you need to keep in mind. It had loyal customer bases who continued to buy cruises and who were not particularly interested in cheap package holidays. CruiseCom is now one of the world's sixth largest cruise company. So students, this time you are not doing for a normal company, you are doing to the world's sixth largest company. So reputation is a very serious thing that you need to keep in mind, students. When measured in terms of passenger capacity, it presently owns 15 ships, which makes it significantly smaller than its largest rival, who operates 30 to 110 ships. So please keep that in mind. So there are rivals who has more capacity than you. So students, there may be chances of investing in new ships, partnering with someone, joint venture, joint arrangement can come inside. So I write down here, IFRS 11 can come inside. Please keep that in mind. Acquisition can come inside. So goodwill calculation, IFRS 3, everything. Please keep that in mind, students. NCI valuation, everything is very much important in the technical area. But it's the largest cruise line in the region, both in terms of numbers of ships and passenger capacity. Regional ties matter because the preference of cruise passengers vary by nationality. So cultural effects can take inside, students. So please keep that in mind. For example, passengers from some countries prefer relaxed and informal atmosphere aboard ship, while others prefer greater formality. Passengers from some countries prefer to take it easy, while others enjoy organized activities and opportunities to interact with other passengers. So students, there are different types of passengers that is involved. So HR, people skill, is very, very important, because you need to train your employees on that. So students, I can also say there is a topic called balance scorecard, which is always tested, which has four things, which is financial perspective, customer perspective, learning and growth perspective, and internal perspective. So I can 100% assume that there can be application here from those theories. So now you need to start applying all the theories, whatever that is possible, into CruiseCom. CruiseCom is Norland's largest cruise line. Its most direct competitor is Waveline and Saildyne. So please keep that in mind, Waveline and Saildyne, based in New York, London. So there are two competitors at the moment. Waveline has 11 ships and Saildyne has 9 ships. So your company has 15 ships, so you are leading at the moment in Nolan. So there can be situation you are going to expand and go ahead in the country because you are sixth in the world. A cruise comes, a business model, it's again the operational knowledge you need to keep in mind, and also the business knowledge you need to keep in mind. Cruise comes fleet consists of 15 large and modern ocean liners. 85% of cruise comes passengers come from Nolan. So only 15% are foreigners. So cultural difference at the moment, they do not have much diversity, but in the exam there can be high diversity, with the remaining of 15 coming mainly from neighboring countries, but with significant minorities coming from further afield. Cruise come, passengers are generally attracted by company's reputation for offering high quality services. Cruise come has a reputation for offering excellent food and entertainment. So already they have a placement in the market. They are positioned for food and entertainment. So they need to follow this if they are going to do any restructuring, because already the customers are interested in this company for this reason. So please keep that in mind, students. In comparison to the most immediate rival, that is Sail Line and you have Wave Line, although its cruise lines are more expensive, it's expensive, it pays close attention to customer feedback. So that's what I told you, balance scorecard can be applied and aims to achieve much repeat business as possible. So this is a clear indication of a balance scorecard application. The company has many customers who has six or more cruises in the past 10 years. The average age of cruise comm passenger is 47. So students, you can be situation there. Youth can come into the picture. There can be a differentiation product that can be created. So project management is a sensitive area that you need to be focusing. Cruise comm ships visits of total 160 ports of call of course a year. The company has two sets of itineraries covering summer and winter. That's what I told you, there are seasonal demand for this. So working capital management will be an issue because they need to take the money carefully and manage it because they have off seasons also. Many destinations are seasonal, some being too hot to be enjoyable places to visit in the summer months, and others being the inhospitable winter because of rain and rough seas. Most ships follow circular routes that includes between 8 to 14 ports of call, of course, of 2 week cycles. Generally, two of the ports are designated at point of embarkation and disembarkation. Passengers wishing a 14-night cruise will join their ships at one of these ports and disembark when the ship returns there 2 weeks later. Those who wish 7-night cruise will join their ship at one of the ports that will leave at another. The embarkation ports are conveniently close to airports. Passengers fly from their local airport to the embarkation port. So again, please keep that in mind, students. There is a relativity between flight industry and the ship industry. They are collected by bus or taxi and either driven to their ships or taken to the hotel to await their ship's arrival. So students, the revenue streams has been clearly mentioned. So these are the three major revenue stream, that is passenger fares. Passengers can book their cruises through Cruise Comm's website. So students, ITIS can come inside the picture. Big data, data mining, data warehouse, in which case they pay directly to their cruise. Alternatively, they can book through travel agents. A travel agents then remit passengers fare to Cruise Comm after deducting their commission. So keep that in mind, students, there is a travel agent also in this case. Passengers can book cruises up to 12 months in advance of the departure date. So students, I will write here IFRS 15 revenue contract. There are 5 stages of revenue contract which you need to apply here. Paying a 10% deposit at the time of booking. The balance of the cost must be paid for at least 7 days before the departure date. So please keep that in mind, students. There is a collection process involved here. Cruise comm's booking system sets fares according to the algorithm that has been developed by the marketing department. The algorithm takes account of the length of the cruise, the time of the year, and the grade of the cabin, and the dining options selected by the passengers. It also takes account of the time until departure and the number of unsold places. The algorithm is designed to maximize revenue overall. For example, fares might be slightly cheaper at the start of the booking period, so the passengers are encouraged to book early. Then the prices rise gradually because customers who book late have less choice and so willing to pay more to ensure booking. Finally, any unsold places may be sold slight discount immediately before the departure, with the discount restricted to avoid encouraging passenger booking date. So students, I am 100% sure benchmarking can come inside this area, and this is similar to the airline sector. Even in the airline industry, when you are booking tickets very early, the prices will be less. In theory, passengers can book cruises up to 48 hours before the departure, like the check-in. Although most cruises are fully booked by then, all bookings made within 30 days of departure must be paid in full at the time of booking. And one more thing, students, you need to keep in mind, ITIS can play a major role here. So students, coming down, let's see the other one. They are telling the onboard extras, which is another source of income. Fares cover the cost, accommodation, meals, including drinks and snacks and entertainment. Passengers can, however, purchase various extras, either in advance or while are aboard. Restaurant upgrades. Each ship has several restaurants. Passengers choose the level of service and the type of food when they book. But they can pay to upgrade a higher class of restaurant as often as they wish during their cruise. Spas and beauty treatment, they are clearly mentioning. Passengers can pay for a variety of treatment from ship's hairstylist and beauty therapist. This extra tends to be more expensive when purchased on board. So students, just keep this in mind. These are the other support activities. So I can just mention, this can be value chain, value analysis. You can just put this knowledge into the picture. Excursion. Passengers can pay extra to upgrade their experience ashore. Cruisecom organization tours that collects passengers from ships and take them to organize tour, usually led by local guide who provides commentary such as destination, offer a choice of tour, each which is different types of areas of interest. The benefit of excursion vary between different destinations. Some have berths for cruise and they are conveniently close to an attractive town or city center, or passenger can sightsee on the foot of their leisure. In the other cases, ship docks in commercial port that are some distance from attraction and some are from transportation is required. Sales of excursions are generally promoted in low-key manner. Please keep that in mind, students. It is promoted at low-key manner. All ships have threads that offer a live show every evening. The show is presided by brief audio-visual presentation about the following day's activities, including availability of show, excursion, and destination. So students, it's a combined activity, so there is again a benefit on this revenue segment. Each ship has its own website, which can be accessed via Wi-Fi through passenger phones or tablet. There is a closed circuit board television network that serves the TVs in cabin. Both the website and television networks advertise excursion. Passengers can book excursion in advance of their cruises at any time while they are aboard. There is a 5% discount for advance purchase made on time of booking the cruise. Passengers are regularly reminded that the space on excursion subject availability and can be sell out. So students, this is one more segment that can be there. So the process and the operation management should be strong here. So students, please keep that in mind. These are the three areas that is there. And I can 100% assume that IFRS 15 has been mostly indirectly mentioned in this case. So please be thorough with the knowledge there. So luckily, if you get that question, I think you can easily pass this examination with a very good score. Students, and these are the other types of revenue sources they have clearly mentioned. Passengers who book their cruise through Cruisecom website can, if they wish, click on their links to the airline and hotels that serve their chosen embarkation point. So there is one more thing, they can do it from a third-party passenger. Cruisecom receives small commission for any sales of flights or accommodation to originate through their website. So they can just connect with the flight providers also. So there can be a connection and made it convenient to the passenger. Cruisecom does not receive any commissions on flights or hotel when passengers book directly through a travel agent. So there can be a situation where they may be promoting these activities. Cruise comes, ship have gifted shops that sell souvenirs and supplies such as sunscreen and toiletries. These are for the convenience of passengers and do not generate a great deal of revenue. Most ships also have retail spaces that are operated by third parties. These generally offer upmarket brands, primary clothing and accessories. The retailers pay a commission instead of paying rent. Passengers' feedback suggests that retailers create an attractive ambience on the ship, even for passengers who do not shop while abroad. So students, here they are providing a commission instead of rent. So there can be a change, relevant costing can come, where you can assess whether can we charge a rental for them. So students, please keep that in mind. This is a very important thing. Now students, the next area we need to consider, the ships. Cruise calm ships are less than 10 years old. Please keep that in mind, less than 10 years old. The company has a reputation for innovation. So again, balanced scorecard, learning and growth in terms of facilities that offers to the passengers. So there can be high chances of proposals in the exam where they may be giving you some tips or some upgradation that can happen. So you need to do an analysis. For example, its newest ship has been designed so that the superstructure creates an atrium around the swimming pools and sun decks. The atrium has been glazed roof that is lightened and darkened electronically to adjust the level of shade to match temperature and brightness of the sun so passengers can relax in comfort even in the hottest day. Cruise Cons commission a new ship roughly once in 18 months. So this is there as a replacement cycle. So please be careful. And students, there is something called capital rationing. I think you may be aware about that divisibility project. In divisibility project, high chances that can also come inside. Each ship is built to high standard, taking advantage of the latest developments in the maritime engineering and also innovation in passenger facilities. Some of these ships are replacement for older ships that are unsuitable for latest updates, and some are addition to increase in the fleet. The company also updates its existing ships on ongoing basis. For example, Cruise Calm was the first cruise line to offer passenger free Wi-Fi connection to the internet on all the ships. So it's a comparative advantage. So they are doing it very neatly until now. And students, just keep that in mind. You need to be more and more industry focused. All Cruise Calm ships are designed to make the best possible use of port of call that they are likely to visit. It would, for example, be possible to increase revenue by building large ships that are carrying more passengers, but ships would be unable to dock every cruise they are going. So students, there is an operational issue also with that. That would require avoiding some popular destination or anchoring offshore or using motorboat to disembark and re-embark passengers. That's a very good point. And I can also suggest one thing called TQM, Total Quality Management. I feel that this company is very high standard and they are also having the total quality management that they are using here. So students, I'll just come down. You will be seeing again the page where they are telling about the Cruise Calm ships are rarely taken out of service for maintenance. Each ship must go into dry lock for once in every 14 days, every 3 years. So students, there is an issue there. It can be break down everything. So you need to be anticipating that. That is required to enable ships to be maintained and painted below the waterline for major refurbishment of bearing seals and other major components of propulsion and steering system that cannot be accessed within the ship. Cruise Calm team has engineers, decorators, fitters. So I'll underline this, engineers, decorators and fitter. Students, you need to mention these people's name in the answer. Some students usually say people, in other words, the employees. Instead of employees, you say the engineers of Cruise Calm, you will be easily attracting the examiner who can be flown to meet the ship to make repairs and refurbishments without serious disruption to the ship's schedule. Public spaces are redecorated and recarpeted overnight. When most passengers are asleep in their cabin, even cabins can be refurbished without taking out of service. Modular wall panels are prefabricated, fully decorated, and electrical ring and plumbing already available to the reverse. This makes it possible to replace cabin interior while passengers are shore. All ships require regular maintenance in addition to the occasional dry dock maintenance, but most of the work can be undertaken while alongside in port or even while cruising. PROSCOM pays great attention to regular preventive maintenance to minimize the likelihood of serious breakdown. Many vital systems have backups that can ensure passenger safety even in the event of malfunction. All ships are equipped with a variety of sophisticated communication systems, including satellite links to the internet, and enable ships' crew members to send and receive email and provide with internet email access through the Wi-Fi system. So technological wise also they are performing really, really well. Life on CruiseCom. Most of CruiseCom passengers aim to spend relaxing time while cruising, making full use of leisure facilities about sea. Students, I can just think about one thing. They can introduce honeymoon packages also. Honeymoon packages they can introduce in the cruise industry. Most passengers enjoy researching and preparing for shore visits, and they spend time both and above below the deck. All ships have swimming pools with deck chairs, sunbeds, so that the passengers can enjoy fresh air and sunshine. The ship theaters host show, performance, and other events. Cruise line often pays celebrities such as authors, artists to present daytime talks and their works. Students, these are the foods they are offering. Cruise passengers often regard mealtime as a major highlight of a day. Cruise come up for three classes of meal. This is the most expensive. Passengers eat small and intimate during the dining room with experienced waiting staff who are trained to offer high standard of service. There's an extensive menu, but passengers can order almost anything they wish to find ingredients there. All members are prepared in order to by the master chef in small kitchen by the caterers only for the government packages. Some passengers pay to have their meal in the government restaurant and also their food. Passengers who choose full service or buffet can pay extra for the meals in government and provided their available table. Now students, when we come to the full service, they are clearly stating in the full service. It's very clear here that this is a mid-price option. So please keep that in mind, students. It's like the mostly economical type where people are served with experienced waiting staff in dining room. Passengers order set menus from menu that they are changing every day. There are four choices, starters, six choices, main courses, and four choices of dinners at the dessert at the dinner. All meals are prepared in ship's main kitchen with some pre-cooking to ensure the speedy service. Passengers can pay to eat all their meals in the full-service restaurant when they book their cruises. They can select the buffet service and pay extra to their meal for full service. And the buffet, the cheapest option that is there is the buffet that takes up the buffet restaurant. The restaurant has extensive seating areas. Passengers can take long as they wish to enjoy their meals. Although the fact that there is no need to place an order and wait for service meal, and buffet systems are consumed relatively quickly. There are no waiting staff other than a team who collects dirty plates and cutlery from the table of the passengers who has eaten, making room for further passengers. The kitchen staff cook batches of food in the main kitchen for buffet throughout meal times, and also a full selection of freshly prepared items and buffet. The buffet is a line fitted heat lamp to keep hot foods and correct temperature until the time is taken and chilled compartment to keep salads and dessert. Passengers can opt for buffet service. They can, when they book their cruises, those who do pay extra have meal on the government full service. And now let's come to the CruiseCom's marketing, which is one of the core factor where they can attract customers. So students, look at here, the CruiseCom marketing. The CruiseCom marketing itself is heavily, partly attract new business from potential passengers who have never been taken CruiseCom's cruise, but also retain custom from who they cruised before. The company spends heavily on television advertising, particularly during winter months when potential passengers generally start to think about annual vacation. These are supported by full-page magazine adverts that are placed in publication that are likely to read by CruiseCom's principal market. CruiseCom has a significant online presence. Passengers are asked to provide their email addresses to consent for receiving new promotional material. So they have a good relationship marketing. So I can use the term here, a relationship marketing is also mentioned. Most passengers agree this. CruiseCom uses information to email a quarterly newsletter supported by monthly personalized email that remind passengers of their recent cruise. The email also indicate how long it will be to the next passenger's cruise, if applicable, and offer suggest excursion relating to cruise cap destination. One of the biggest challenge facing CruiseCom's marketing department is that the company is consistently changing its cruises, new ships and modification to exist ships, offer new facilities and attraction that must be promoted carefully to ensure they yield the greatest competitive advantage. CruiseCom also keeps a list of destination under the review and frequently experiment with new ports of call, again requiring marketing department to consider how best to promote and advertise these changes. The planned launch of new ships provides opportunity to increase CruiseCom's passenger capacity. The company does not necessarily withdraw an existing ship from service when it adds a new vessel into the fleet. The new ships are often created in itineraries. The CruiseCom can offer wider ranges. So students, this is the organizational structure. So I will clearly mention here the people skill is very much important. And students, here you have non-executive directors also. So please remember the committees that are there. Risk committee, remuneration committee, nomination committee. Okay, please keep that in mind, and audit committee. So students, if you look at here, Bella Lynn, the finance person, so you will be little working with Bella Lynn. Marvis, the marketing, operational and hotel operation. And students, one issue is the IT is not much. So I think we need to understand the IT falls on the operation, and even HR, I think it's falling under the operational side. The finance director is responsible for all external finance management as well as administration function, purchasing and information technology. The marketing director is responsible for all aspects of sales promotion and revenue maximization. The marine director is responsible for all aspects of management CruiseCom fleet of ships, including ship design, modification, maintenance and safety. The hotel operations director is responsible for all services offered by passengers while on board the CruiseCom ships, that includes food, cleaning, excursion, and entertainment. The ship crews here, they have mentioned the captain, who is the most important person, a tech department, engineering department, navigation safety, engine, electric supply, hotel department, food, housekeeping, guest services, and entertainment. Students, the Wi-Fi, everything, I think that may fall under the guest services, so you need to keep in mind. And students, whenever you are writing the answer, please relate it to the relevant department in the questions when you are doing it. The ship captain is an experienced and highly qualified deck officer who is qualified to command the ship. This is a significant responsibility because decision made by the captain affect the safety for everyone in boat, both passengers and crew. A ship can also create a collision hazard for other ships if it is navigated incorrectly. Legal, the captain is responsible for safe operation of ships, and his or her commands must be obeyed at all times. The members of deck departments are ship officers and other trained crew members who are primarily responsible for duties such as navigating the ship, keeping the watch of surrounding sea, and procedures associated with the docking of the ships. The engineering department is responsible for the safe and efficient operations in the ship engine. Most large ships are powered by diesel engines to drive propeller and electrical generators. Engineers consistently monitor the engine, gearbox, and element of propulsion. So I can say internal failure cost and external failure cost. So I'll just mention here internal failure cost and external failure cost can come. The engineering department is also responsible for operation and maintenance of other systems such as ship's electrical supply, associated systems such as air conditioning and maintenance. Senior members of board and deck engineering department must be qualified and experienced before they can work in an unsupervised aboard ship. So it's an unsupervised aboard ship. So that can be one of the threat also, and that can be, again, there can be strength also. So high chances of upside and downside risk. Senior members of both deck and engineering department must be qualified and experienced before they work unsupervised aboard ship. The hotel department is so called because its staff fulfill function that can be found in most large hotels. A food preparation and service is a major part of business passenger experience. A cruise calm ship generally have three classes of restaurant on board: a buffet, full service, and gourmet. Preparing the service and meals is not much different from working in similar restaurants or hotel dining rooms online. Kitchen staffs do, however, have to take particular care over fire safety, even though ships are designed to avoid spreads of fire and smoke. Staffs must also take great care over hygiene because of infection that can spread rapidly between ship passengers. That is particularly a problem because a ship replenishes fresh provisions almost daily on a widely variety supplies of different ports. The quality control can be different. So student, I can just circle this entire thing. This can become a particular issue trigger. There can be a proposal trigger, and this can be an issue trigger. Issue trigger is where there is high chances of having a problem. And housekeeping staffs are responsible for keeping the cabins and public areas of the ship clean and tidy. The role of virtually same the shoreboard counterpart. Guest services interact with passengers and must be capable of resolving any problems or complaints in a diplomatic manner. They are also responsible for promoting the sale of the shore excursion and other services such as spa treatment. Hotel department staffs can access passenger booking records using satellite links both before the cruises commence and throughout the duration of the cruises. The ability to access the data enables hotel department staff to ensure that all passengers receive standard of service and have paid for the check bookings in the event the passenger had a query. Entertainers are expected to offer varied selection shows of passengers on two-week cruise who can attend the ship theater every night without getting bored. Most ships have band and trope dancers and one or two headline acts, usually singers. Some cruise come previous headline acts has gone in the celebrities. So this is the extract from the monthly performance report. The cruise calm senior management received monthly performance breakdown of operating revenues and cost, showing the results of company for 15 ships. So students, I can write here ABC, there is something called activity based costing. ABM, there is something called activity based management. So this knowledge can be recalled here. The following extract shows a recent analysis for company's newest ship, the MY Chrono, a ship that was lost. So newest ship, I can also say learning curve. There's a topic called learning curve which you can keep in mind because it's a new ship. New staffs may be recruited, everything. These figures reflect efficiency of ships and their crews and also routes between follow. The ship follow the summer routes for months of April to September and winter routes and the remaining years. The MV Chrono is the larger in the two ships that allows certain economies of scale such as crew numbers in deck and engineering department being relatively unaffected by the ship's size. Despite larger ships being able to carry more passengers, ticket prices for MV Krona's summer cruise are higher than MV Bhatia's Krona follow popular route of 11 stops in 14 days compared with Batavia 9 stops. Ticket revenues are shown gross commission paid to travel agent and associated cost of getting passengers off the airport are shown separately as expenses. Showing ticket revenue gross in makes revenue earned of the ships. So students, you can just go through the ships that are operating in here. So you can understand that most of the ships are profitable other than the Batavia. It's a little drop in profit, but occupancy level are 90s, which is really good in a ship industry. And it's a very, very good indicator. There is a slight variance, but still it looks fine. And students, here they have given the revenue analysis. You can just go through this for the time being. And the financial analysis, again, students, you can check in my Facebook page where I have commented the link below, which has the ratio calculations. You can just analyze that. I have already done it in the Facebook. And the competitor analysis is also mentioned here. And now, students, this is the most important thing, the articles. Now, students, here, cruise, calm, ship, balcony is to become a thing of the past. So, here they are going to bring a more upgraded version of a cruise where you need to go through this. So, this can be a potential investment appraisal theory. Yeah, even one competitor can start also. And students, cruise car ship losing their welcome. Again, this is a threat that is taking place in some of the destination because of unorganized tour arrangement. Because people are finding it very difficult to accommodate around 3,000 passengers. And also the passengers are also making negative reply. And then students, it's one of the support activity. One of the celebrity chef has started working in our competitor company. And I think you are clear that our competitor company has taken this. So he's promoting in Waveline that you need to eat healthy food. And so our company is also most popular. So there can be an issue that our food has having a food poison or due to unorganized issue, their taste may be less. And then students, this is a benchmarking, generic benchmarking. They have done where they can track the customers when they are going on excursion, so that they won't miss any customer. So I can assume that this instrument can be developed and there can be some implementation issues also. And then students, there's a contract from one of the economic shipbuilder where he is trying to start a new ship so that giving passengers. So there can be opportunities where budget cruisers also can come into the picture. But still, I believe that our company is a very, very old company. So people traveling in our company will definitely have a prestigious value. And then the business daily, which clearly says that the Minister of Finance boosts tax depreciation to stimulate investment. So students, again, keep in mind that IAS 12, which is a deferred tax, high chances they can test. So they are clearly mentioning. So please study the deferred tax area as is a listed company and no frill airline cancel route. In other words, budget airlines are cancelling the route. So there will be a direct impact on cruise industry because some of the passengers travel and come to your location via flight. So this can have an issue to you. So there can be diversification option where cruise comes can start airline industry. Diversification can take place. So please keep that in mind where you can buy a loss making company. So students, I believe that you are happy with the analysis, and if you have any doubts, please comment on the comment box. Good luck, everyone. God bless you all.